Okay, hopefully this time we can really end it. I was hoping for a much faster success in that card, but Mr. Skywalker is
not adequately supporting me on this
very
mission,
slippery.
And it has failed.
Just can't catch him. The actual battle has stopped a long time ago. What do we have? 5? Another assault. We get something? It'll tell us if we get Luke. It's important enough. Yeah. Didn't even do an uprising. We had just enough troops to avoid that. But we do need someone, a skilled diplomat here. Fucking lost the save. Come on, please, please, please end soon. Next 1,000 turns. I'd say the game was decided probably before even turn 300 or 400. So this is, has been a long sweep up effort, basically. Very, very long one. So I'm definitely appreciating the headquarters only victory a lot more at this point.
You have not adequately supported me on this mission, and it has failed.
Doubtlessly, that was the reason, and the only reason it failed. Okay, what's happening? Jesuard joins us. Bork. Slowly but surely, we're getting them. That's the last one here. So, more sectors we have full control of. I think they might actually require diplomacy, because we have a ton of troops here. This should have ended a long time ago. They just keep going and going and going. or trust. Three more. And here goes Warmrick. A bog. Get the neutral Cesar and join us. We'll get you, Skywalker. We'll get you. Mana. That's it. Oh, we got a Delta. Soon we'll get them. I know it joins. Boris. Next, Lilmara. Yeah, again, we don't see anything that the rebellion has that it could continue. Just doesn't end. Where? Oh crap. Oh, the alien joins enemy. Always they have some colony they can fall back on. But that takes a solid diplomat to be able to pull. And I'm sort of wondering what their diplomat is. It could be Skywalker, certainly. Thrawn, I think, he's a weak diplomat, but great leader. The value 125 is when without the Emperor's bonus. Others, the value is probably something below 100 usually. So, one of the better leaders you'll get. Ooh, uprising ends. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Mission Dega, subdue uprising. How many troops do you need here? Quite a lot. There's a ton of troops here. Six more troops here. One of our prisoners escaped. You can't always stop that in any way. This is where they're coming. Misery, how many turns do we need to wait? About 6. After that, we'll invade. Long time ago. Let's go finish this. Yeah, things are looking okay. They have to run out of places to hide soon. Every day, fewer and fewer places await them. 5. Why did I move this here? Quite sure. Okay, I dig out. Certainly have the troops we need. Just wait, see what happens. Tatooine joins us. Lovely. Another sector in our complete control. Surely we're ending soon. All right, two guys. Board. Her. No.
As you wish. I have been successful.
Okay, what do they have? They don't really have anything. Hopefully, this will be the end. Again. Please. It's not. We got Borsk Fela, that's a spy diplomat. Uprising begins. Orsk failure. And Snoop Snoop. Snoop Snoop captured. I think we have a good leader here. No, we don't. We need to feel one. We need to transfer tons of troops here. Turns to we have to wait 10 turns, so by god, it's never going to end. There's a diplomat already going there. What about here? Yeah, the emperor is going there. What about here? No one's going there. So. Well, maybe there is someone going there. We could send more guys. Where could you possibly still hide? Altar. This is in our total control. Sumitra in our total control. Influence keeps spreading and spreading. There's four sectors that have potential locations they can be. That can't last for long. Much left, really. Really. There's maybe 20-30 systems that could potentially have something. And their numbers get reduced all the time now. That's We have a solid diplomat coming here. Yeah, there's no need for Thrawn to do diplomacy. I think we'll go orbit straw tools. That's the way we have one fleet blockading one of these systems, and two will be use diplomacy for them to get them in control. Stay here, I don't want to start any trouble. If I invade them by force, they might start causing serious trouble in other places. It's not worth it. Okay. Abort. Do a mission there. Really? Probably go around and start invading places. System has joined the alliance. My God. It's amazing how fast they can spread here. I think it's because they basically have no other thing they can do at this moment. Either they spread very fast or that's the end. They really don't have any choice. Soon. What place was it? Wait, Crago. Not much we can do here. Uprising it. Diplomacy? No. So, yeah, I think diplomacy is what you need to end uprising. Or otherwise, I have a terrible luck with these guys. we get them to. Maybe 5. That's not a problem. Okay. Gandolo is. You have. You need 10. My god. I would probably send 6 from here alone. Indoor can't send anything. And Dega. No, we can't. Definitely can send something. That should be enough. Yeah.
The Emperor will be most.
Game over. Game over, man. Jesus Christ.
Serve the Empire well. The Emperor will surely reward victory.
This insignificant rebellion has been crushed. The shattered fragments of the Rebel Alliance lie broken before the indomitable forces of the Galactic Empire. In the darkest cells of the Imperial Palace, the Rebel leaders languish in chains. The last of the Jedi Knights is a captive of the Empire. Order has been restored to the galaxy. Even though victorious, the Empire must remain vigilant. The agents of chaos are forever present and even now are fanning the embers of dissent to ignite the flame of rebellion. And that was Star Wars Rebellion. What can I say about it? In certain aspect this reminds me of Ascendancy, in that it is as Ascendancy was basically a lot of good, well-made atmospheric content and great ideas, but the implementation basically fails miserably on all fronts. On here, well, it's Star Wars, it's very interesting, at least for me, and as a science fiction... as a science fiction strategy game, very interesting. This isn't quite as bad as Ascendancy, there's a lot of good ideas again, but some of the implementation on some of them actually works quite well. Problem is, well, the problem is this isn't very engaging in the fluff department or in the gameplay department. many of the strategy parts work just fine. The problem is the AI is again retarded to the point that it doesn't allow you to get a decent challenge. You have to sort of give up sectors to him, or otherwise he's played out of the fight in very early on. Then the actual combat and things like that, they aren't very visual or gameplay, they just happen. So you could improve upon this basic concept in a very various ways and make a lot better game. And in some aspect the Star Wars Empire 4 does exactly this, especially the fleet fights are a total piece of crap. They're not in the conceptual way a bad thing, but in practical terms they tend to be very shitty. A lot of the 3D commands or fleet movements you can give them are basically totally pointless. I'm gonna load, yeah, thank god, I'll kill the music. The 3D fleet fights serve no purpose at all, and it just makes the camera controls, movement controls, combat controls, they're all very limited or bad. The combat is limited in the sense that you can only give overall objectives, you can't really do anything. It's not even in the real-time strategy sense, or even a strategy game sense. You can't, it's very hard to come to have any kind of fleet formations or things like that. You just give them a generic command to attack fighters, attack starships, and that's it. With starship you can attack a single target you want, so that works a little bit better. But after that they go into range, stop there and shoot until something dies, so it's not that engaging there. The tactical portion is basically pretty poor. There is something that works well, and that's the fleet composition. There's a good balance between the starships and starfighters. If you try to just make it with one or the other, that probably isn't gonna go too well for you. And then there are the ion cannons versus lasers, turbo lasers versus lasers, torpedoes that go chew through hull in seconds. So it has a sort of a good potential, but everything feels sort of a could at minimum use a significant amount of polish, but on almost all you could use a second iteration on the entire feature, and that's really the problem here. This is a amazing game that simply, but there's too much that brings it down. It has a very good ideas, well made ideas even, that has a solid sort of a core that if you play this and really get it, you probably have very fond sort of attitude towards the game, because this does some things better than any other game I've played. But there's so much bad in this, or unengaging, so I wouldn't be surprised if there are a lot of people who try this that hate this game and think this is a giant pile of shit. And I can't really blame them, because a lot of areas in this game are really bad and clumsy and look ugly, so yeah, I'm sort of torn between this. In very few aspects, this is a great combination of strategy, Star Wars, and unique ideas that you a unique take on certain things, the popular support. Very clever, very interesting, and the way it works is very simple, but it's very fundamental and deep at the same time. It's a very, very good idea. Excellent idea, in fact. But yeah, in other aspects, this simply can't compete. It's another sort of, yeah, ascendancy really comes to mind. So depending on what you lash onto, you'll probably have either this sort of a classic game for you, or you think it's a totally useless piece of shit. And I can't really blame, I think both attitudes towards this game are just as valid. There's just people valuing different parts of this game.